术之城，美丽之地，重庆，行千里，致广大。
Wasalna fil China Cultural Center li instab ġewwa Melita Street, il-Belt Valletta, għal programmi ħor ta' din il-ġimgħa. F'din is-sensiela ta' programmi dwar ċina qegħdin naqsmu magħkom il-kollaborazzjoni bejn iċ-Ċina u Malta u nippruvaw nagħtu esperjenza tal-kultura sinjura ta' Ċina li tistgħu issegwu minn darkom stess. Il-pajjiż Ċiniż huwa kbir b'aktar minn 30 provinċja u 56 gruppi etniċi.
These oracle inscriptions possessed the basic elements of Chinese calligraphy, which had a tremendous influence on subsequent carving and calligraphy techniques. Stroke by stroke, Chinese characters constructed a civilized world. This is the place where the Chinese language set forth to spread Chinese civilization to all corners of the world.
So I think I arrived in Malta February 2017. So, you know, we have a Chinese language institute in University of Malta under the umbrella of the Faculty of Arts, Oriental Study Department. We established 2000 line. So we have 6 staff there. So it is 10 years already we worked in Malta. So our mission is for teaching Chinese language and promote Chinese culture. Chinese language department, it is a branch of Oriental Study Department. So we have that is established jointly by a Chinese university, or Xiamen University, and the University of Malta. So I can tell you this cooperative project, so 10 years. So our students, most of our students are from University of Malta. Of course, majority of them are Maltese, but some from other European countries. So all students were enrolled by the university. We give the lecture, give them training. We have a Chinese degree, Chinese diploma. We also have a degree plus of Chinese courses to the students, all of the university. You know, we also have a teaching point in some local secondary schools like St. Louis, St. Margaret, GC College, St. Anton, and so on. Hurt like this, try. Difficult, like this.
Like this.
Like this. 1, 2, 3, yeah. Yeah, okay. Okay, you can try. Chinese character is ideography, came from picture. Now I can, for example, let me tell you, you can write this. One stick means one. Yeah, the meaning is one. The Chinese is E, we pronounce E, but in fact the meaning is one, because it's one stick. So I can see this. Beautiful. Yeah. Two sticks means two. Chinese pronunciation is er. Okay? So I can see. Yeah, now you understand. Can see? Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Can you guess the meaning?
Mm-hmm.
Can you guess the meaning? No. If I tell you this is came from the picture of this, now you understand.
Legs.
It's a person.
It's a person, okay.
Chinese pronunciation is Ren, the meaning is a person.
Okay, Zenu.
A person. You are Ren.
Okay.
I am a Ren, okay?
Okay.
Try a stick above a person.
Mm-hmm. A stick first?
A stick above a person.
Okay.
Beautiful. Can you guess the meaning? When a person grow big enough, his hair is longer, need a stick to hold it.
That
means
okay.
Means big.
Okay, big. Uh-huh.
Big.
I see. This is big.
That's a big.
It's beautiful, huh?
Something above big. Something above big.
God.
Yeah.
Yes?
Beautiful. Something above big. Yeah, beautiful.
The sky.
Sky, okay. Let me see.
Chinese people, pronunciation is
tian,
but it's sky.
Sky, okay.
You are right.
God.
Traditionally, Chinese people regard the sky as God.
But Malta, God.
Yes. When your people say, my God, the Chinese people say,
my sky.
My sky.
I understand. Okay.
One stick cross, then the other stick. Can you guess the meaning?
What sort of ink is that?
The ink. This ink is from China.
Uh-huh. What is it?
Particularly for Chinese handwriting and painting.
Beautiful.
If you don't know this, the meaning, I tell you, you see this someplace. Mm-hmm. What is this?
A cat.
Cat.
Yes?
It's a tiger.
Oh, tiger, okay.
You know,
but a tiger.
That okay. Chinese saying, tiger is the king of the forest. See, this is a symbol of a tiger.
Okay.
So the meaning is king.
Okay.
This character means king.
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 Okay.
Yeah. King. So our pronunciation is one cross, a little stick. The meaning is
king.
King. Now you learn.
King.
Beautiful. What's your name? If you give me your English name, I can write in. Ni. If your name write in Chinese way by the pronunciation.
Ni. so beautiful.
Really?
Very beautiful, yes. I cannot do that.
But
that's very difficult.
But you need to practice. It will
yes.
take a long time for you to practice it.
Yes.
But it's not so difficult.
Yeah.
You can learn step by step.
Mm.
Yeah. Yeah. Beautiful. Beautiful, you know? it's a very popular
yes.
surname in China.
Okay, all right.
So have a lot of population
very
with
nice.
A surname. Chinese pronunciation is Li.
Okay.
Yi. It's very similar.
Similar.
That's all.
Very nice.
Very nice.
Very
okay.
nice.
Yeah. So
do you go to China often?
Well, once 1 year. All our teachers
mm-hmm.
Are granted annual leave.
Mm-hmm.
So, but often we will take the chance like university vacation.
Mm-hmm.
So that time we have small students.
Mm-hmm.
Our teacher, mm-hmm. including me, will go back to China. Normally
yes.
we have once 1 year.
1 year.
Yeah.
And your family is here with you in Malta?
My wife is here.
She
follows me.
Here.
She likes
yes.
Malta. Malta is a very beautiful, beautiful scenery, beautiful weather, friendly people. We like it.
Yes,
so
that's good.
At the beginning, she just came here for visiting me.
Yes.
But since she arrived, she liked this place. Then she applied for residential permission.
Yes.
And stay here. I stay
yes.
here more than 2 years.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Lovely. What do you like most about Malta?
I think the historical scenery. Mm. It represents the long history of European.
Yes.
Yeah, a lot of history about European history we learned when I was in Chinese school. But now we can witness it. We can see it with our own eyes.
Yes.
So a lot of famous historic
yes.
relics.
Yes.
And also I think the people here is very friendly.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody can enjoy peaceful life in Malta. So that is why we like it.
History of Chinese civilization, we may feel that the unique Chinese characteristics are all around us and within us, which is to a large extent reflected in Kung Fu. Kung Fu, or martial arts, can only be mastered through hard work and practice, which contains rich yet profound Chinese philosophy. Whether in curing diseases and improving health, or in subduing the enemy and preventing conflict, Kung Fu can have an effect on the daily lives of Kung Fu fighters. All styles or schools of martial art originate from Shaolin Temple. Today, Shaolin Kung Fu has become a window of Chinese culture to the world, which also turns Shaolin Temple into the most influential holy land of martial arts in the world. Kung Fu is a collection of wisdom. Kung Fu is the honing of will. Kung Fu is the heritage of skills. Kung Fu is the essence of a rising culture.
I was very interested to find out how you started with this interest of yours in martial arts.
Hi Leah, thank you very much for having me with you today. My interest for martial arts actually grew with me through the years. Basically when I was a young kid and my father used to watch Bruce Lee movies and actually got me interested in the Kung Fu tradition and culture of the beautiful Chinese people. Through the years, I trained various martial arts until I reached a stage where I understood and found out that, unfortunately, when people think about Kung Fu, they only see the martial side of it. I mean literally the physical. However, there's way more behind it. There's a whole 4,000 years of Chinese cultures behind it. There's people don't know about the philosophy, about the traditional methods of teaching, the names of the moves that represents all philosophical concept behind it. So when I started looking around myself in Malta, I understood that there were many very good martial artists here. Yes, indeed, there are great schools. However, there was no one that was going into depth as much as I wanted to. And that's when I started looking around for either travel to China or abroad to find out more about this beautiful, wonderful culture. I was lucky enough to find an association in Italy which invites every year constantly free grandmasters from China and goes to China on a regular basis. So I basically joined this association and I started traveling and learned some more. And every time I learn something, I come back down and I share what I learn with my students.
What are the names of the Chinese martial arts that you specialize in?
Right. First of all, we do traditional Chinese wushu. Wushu includes all martial arts in the Chinese language. We specialize in Qi Xing Tan Lang Quan, which translates to Seven Star Praying Mantis. It's basically a style of Kung Fu which was based on the actual insect. And we also do regular Qigong exercises for health. And the very popular Tai Chi Chuan. Tai Chi Chuan is basically a martial art that takes care of teaching you how to improve your health and fight at the same time in a very slow manner. Mm-hmm.
Do you believe that Chinese martial arts contributes to a better lifestyle, a better way of life,
absolutely,
and better health? Do you think it contributes to health?
Absolutely.
In what
way? It's something that I highly recommend to everyone. Unlike other kind of martial arts, Chinese wushu concentrates mainly on self-control. Self-control meaning self-knowledge, understanding who you are before you can do any movement. The movement is your last scope, is the last scope of the actual art. First you integrate the art, then the discipline, then the martial aspect. And I can actually tell you, through the years, I've seen a huge difference in my kids' behavior, in my students' behavior. For example, I would recommend it to anyone who has a cheeky kid running around. With Kung Fu, not only they bond with other kids and they learn how to understand their body and understand how strong they are, they actually understand how to interact with people by listening to themselves. Do you see what I mean?
What is the recommended age for children to start?
Properly, I would say after the 6 years of age. Before, it would be a very nice game, but perhaps there are other arts that are more appropriate from 3 years old to six, because I receive actually many requests about it. After 6 years of age, kids are more capable of concentrating and paying attention to the exercise itself. It shouldn't be longer than an hour. Anyway.
And what type of discipline should they follow when they're young? Would it be Tai Chi?
I always recommend to start with Praying Mantis Kung Fu first. Why? Because it's more active. And Tai Chi, for example, to youngsters, I would suggest it by the age of 12, 13. When they're actually ready for more self-discipline, if you know what I mean. Mm-hmm.
And what about women? I mean, we see a lot of men participating in martial arts. How can
right.
and women adapt martial arts, perhaps a gentle form of martial arts, into their daily routine?
You said it, gentle form.
Routine.
Absolutely.
Yes.
In fact, women tend to prefer Tai Chi Chuan over Mantis Kung Fu. Why is that? Because they see it more gentle, more graceful, kind of slower. However, Kung Fu has no limit. I would suggest, highly recommend Kung Fu to women, to men, any age, at any stage of life, whatever your need is, you know? It's something that helps you building self-confidence and gaining awareness of your body and taking control of your life.
I've heard many people saying that they find peace within themselves when they do some form of Chinese martial arts.
I always tell my students, through my movements, I found my peace. I used to suffer of, I don't want to call it a nervous breakdown a few
years ago.
Anxiety,
perhaps.
Absolutely, anxiety, you said it. And I can tell you that thanks to the techniques of breathing, the techniques of calming down, my life has changed completely.
That's lovely to hear. And one final question. I know you're going to demonstrate some Tai Chi today, but with people who are more elderly, there are more elderly people today that are still very active. What would you recommend, Gino?
The art and Chinese Kung Fu has no limit. No limit of age, no limit of movements. The movement has to be done according to one's capability. So if someone goes down, it doesn't mean that you have to go down. You can go as down as you are capable of, or as the maximum you can achieve, you know? At the end of the day, Chinese martial arts, it's something that, what my teachers always tell me, for example, they say, your Kung Fu will never be my Kung Fu, because my Kung Fu depends on my capabilities. Your Kung Fu depends on your capabilities. So the wonderful art of Kung Fu continues on evolving, which means if you are over 50, and I have students over 50, can I show you something real quick?
For sure, I'm going to.
There are certain movements that I don't really recommend to people of a certain age, which however I force my little kids to do, things like that.
Yes.
You see what I mean?
So yes.
Going back in answering your question, Kung Fu and Tai Chi depends on your capabilities.
Yes, so. And one very final question, how popular is it in Malta today?
Tai Chi is extremely popular, I have to say. Thanks also to the efforts of everyone, the whole scene of Tai Chi in Malta. Thanks also to the efforts of China Cultural Center, who kept on promoting it over, and thanks to the medical team who promoted Qigong with it. It's popular enough. The problem is that people still believe that it's a gymnastic for old people, when in reality it's not at all.
Yes.
Try it to believe it.
I will. Thank you, Gino.